Hi, everybody. I am Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, here to tell you that it's still summer. Yes, and that means there's still summer movies out there. Now, I got two of them for you this weekend, and one of them is good, and the other one is Hollywood crap. So let's start with the Hollywood crap, which would be...
Bieber!
It is not Bieber. Would you people stop with Bieber? Bieber is not in Cowboys and Aliens, but I will tell you that it would have been a better movie if Bieber was in it. Instead, it has Indiana Jones in the person of Harrison Ford as a cowboy, and Daniel Craig, James Bond. Indy meets 007. How perfect. And the idea is kind of fun, too. I mean, an Old West 1875 movie which is attacked by UFOs and aliens that come out in one good scene in this movie where you see the alien aircraft come down and they get wires and they lasso cowboys, suck them into their ship and do God knows what with them. And the problem is we don't know God knows what. They don't show it. It's PG-13. It's directed by Jon Favreau and he does the same thing he did with Iron Man versus Iron Man 2. Remember how good Iron Man was?
Yeah.
Remember how Iron Man 2 sucked? This is what happens. All the daring is gone. All the setup is gone. Cowboys, Harrison Ford looked like he was ready to play a mean bastard. Instead, he starts giving lessons to kids about manhood, trying to understand the aliens. Now, the aliens themselves, what do they look like? You know, they look like everything from the first Alien movie, but they have little hands and they go like this. And these little hands creep out. And it was like momentarily creepy. But, you know, what is it going to be? It doesn't mash up right. I mean, it's trying to be a mashup, but instead, both the aliens and the cowboys are shooting blanks. I'm sorry, you know, go. Write me, email me, do all the crap and say, you suck. This is really a great movie. You're crazy if you think it's good. But there is a good movie, and you have to look for this one because it's an indie movie, but it's called Attack the Block. It comes from the Brits who know what they're doing. They had no money. And there's a new director and writer named Joe Cornish. And he's the one who has come up with the idea for this, that the aliens would come in and attack the projects in London, where all these gangbangers are there with their guns and they're doing, they got that little twist with the gun. It's hilarious. It's also exciting. And it kind of bites for real. These aliens are all a bunch of little furball dogs. And they got dago teeth. And individually, they don't scare you, but together, when they climb the side of a building and they come after you, it's amazing. And there's a point to this movie because there's a new actor in it named John Boyega, who is terrific. He plays Moses. He's the head of this gang. And he sets this whole story up by, first of all, mugging a really sweet nurse at knife point. And then he and his gang become the heroes because who else can take on aliens but gangbangers? This movie is fast, it's short, it's vicious, it's bloody, it's all the non-wussy things that horrible Cowboys and Aliens has never thought of doing because it's trying to sell you popcorn and crap and mush. So okay, repeat after me. The movie I'm seeing this weekend, if I like aliens, is Attack the Block and not Cowboys and Aliens.
Yeah.
I say it, and I'm Peter Travers.
Yeah.
Yeah.